Okay, here I have given you two set of sentences, right? Just take a glance at this and tell me what is the difference between these two sets. Look at the verbs. If you observe carefully, you'll find that in the first sentence, the action performed by the doer passes on to something else, passes on to an object. He kicked what? He kicked the ball. Okay? She ate what? An apple. And he is reading a book. Okay? So you'll find that the action performed by the doer is passed on to an object. Okay? So if you ask the question, kicked what? You have to get an answer, right? If you ask, ate what? Then you get an answer. In short, all these verbs take an object. Okay? They have an object to which they pass on the action. But what about this set? He slept late. He slept what? Is late the answer? No. Late is not the answer for slept what. The man coughed loudly. There is no receiver of the action. Okay? The action is not being passed on to any object. Here also, the dog died. Okay? Is the action passed on to any object? No. So in short, these verbs does not take any object. These verbs do not take any object. So, these kind of verbs are what we call transitive verbs. And these are what we call intransitive verbs. Okay, so I hope the explanation is clear. Transitive verbs take an object. Okay, here the noun passes on the action to an object, whereas here that doesn't happen. There is no object and the action is not passed on. Okay. Now what you should remember is that sometimes the same verb can be used as transitive as well as intransitive. Let's look at examples. Here we know in both these sentences the verb used is transitive, right? She sang a sad song. Okay, she sang what? A sad song. So there is an object. The horse kicked the man. So who did the horse kick? We know the horse kicked the man. So there is an object. Now the same verb, sang, I can use as intransitive. Is there an object here? Is there an object? No, there is no object. What is well? Well describes the verb sang, so it's only an adverb. Okay. So the action is not being passed on. The same thing with this sentence. The horse kicked the man. I can say, this horse never kicks. If I say this horse never kicks, then there is no object there. Okay. So from this we should gather that the same verb can be transitive as well as intransitive. So it depends on usage. Okay. But we should remember that there are certain verbs which are always intransitive. They cannot be used as transitive. So I'll give you examples for those. Okay. All these words are always intransitive. Okay, so these words cannot be used transitively. Okay, so this was only a short introduction to verbs. Now let's move on to our main topic. Our main topic is tenses. So I've already told you, tense is a form which the verb takes to indicate time. So now you can tell me how many basic tenses are there in the language. There are three, right? Which are they? Which are those basic tenses? Present, past and future, right? But then they again can be divided into subtypes, isn't it? So let's see what are those subtypes and how we can form them. So we'll take the same sentence, okay? Let's go to present tense first. Present tense. So the first type of present tense is simple present tense, right? Let's take an example sentence. I write a letter. Okay. When used in, so here we know I is first person. Okay. So there are three persons in English: first person, second person, and third person. So let's form the same sentence using second person. You write a letter. And when used in third person, he writes. It is writes. He writes a letter. Right? So the simple present tense doesn't need much explanation, I suppose. Right? So when is the simple present tense used? We'll come back to it later. Okay, we'll have a separate session for usage of all tenses, but right now we are only inspecting the form of each tense. Okay, after inspecting the form of each tense, we'll come back and discuss the usage. Okay, right now let's focus on the form. So this is simple present tense. Now what next? Present continuous. now it becomes I am writing. Okay, writing a letter. Okay, hereafter I won't be mentioning a letter, it's understood. Okay, I am writing, you are writing. And she is writing. Okay. So from this we gather that the basic form is subject plus is or are or am plus the verb plus ing, right? So usually this is the basic format for present continuous. So next, present perfect. So in present perfect, the same sentence will become I have written a letter and you have written a letter. And she has. Here it becomes has. She has written a letter. Alright. So now, can we formulate the basic structure? It will be subject plus has or have plus, yes, past participle of verb. Okay, and you should remember that this is not the end, plus object or plus the rest of the sentence. So this part corresponds only to this half of the sentence. We know that a letter is there, that is object here. Okay, so since we are not writing the object here, we are ignoring the rest of the sentence. Okay, so this much corresponds only to this part of the sentence. So this is present perfect. Now which is the next tense? Present perfect continuous. So present perfect continuous form of the first sentence will be I have, I have been writing a letter. And for you it's you have been writing a letter, and she has or have has she has been writing a letter. So here the format is subject plus has or have plus been. Okay, here been is a new entry, been plus verb plus ing. Fine. So this is all in present tense.